Hi, everyone. Danielle Pennington here from BestWay Mortgage with your mortgage tip of the day. Oftentimes, I get phone calls from agents and clients who are wondering, what is the difference between a pre-qualification and a pre-approval? I wanted to share with you the difference today and let you know what you can expect. Pre-qualification is essentially information that you have verbally provided to a lender. You've told them how much you make, you've told them how much you have in the bank, and you've told them what you think your credit score is. They haven't pulled credit and they haven't viewed any of that documentation to make sure that it all matches up with what you've told them. They're going to give you a rough estimate of what you can afford based on that, but it's not a very strong document. What you really want to do if you're getting ready to shop for a mortgage is to first get pre-approved. A pre-approval is a much stronger document because once you've verbally given me all of your information, I'm then going to back it up with the documentation to support it. I'm going to ask for pay stubs, bank statements, your employer, things of that nature that let us know that we're really dealing with the facts. We've pulled the credit, we've seen what's on it, we know exactly what the score is, and now I'm going to then tell you exactly what you can afford. It's not an estimate of what you can afford, it's a really strong document. And there's a reason that this is important. Many times a real estate agent won't even want to show you houses until you've been fully pre-approved by a lender. And this is a safety to each of you. You want to make sure that you're not out looking at houses that are outside of your price range, that you potentially might fall in love with, and in the end up very upset that you can't actually afford them. And the real estate agent wants to make sure that they're only sending you things that are within your price range so that when you're looking at houses, you know that they're houses that you can actually make an offer on. Speaking of offers, think about a seller of a home who's receiving two different documents from two different buyers. One buyer is pre-qualified, the other buyer is pre-approved. As a seller, which buyer do you think they're going to take more seriously? Definitely the pre-approved buyer. So it's something that's very important. It also can increase your negotiation abilities. If it's you up against the pre-qualified buyer again, and there's maybe a time concern, the pre-approved buyer is going to be stronger because they know that that bank and lender has the documents all set up and ready to go. Speaking of, it also saves time. If I'm gathering all of your information up front, once you do place an offer and are ready to move forward with a purchase, I have everything I need to turn it over and get started on the process right away. We're not going to waste days gathering documentation and trying to put a file together, you know, under a rush. I'll have everything I need, we'll get your offer submitted, and we'll make sure that we're getting you closed as soon as possible. My name is Danielle Pennington with your mortgage tip of the day. If you have any questions, please don't hesitate to call or email me.